turn the puck over. That's got to be below the hash marks.
Oh, a little back pass in front. Almost worked as driving the net was Talbot. Oh. And then down to the ice goes Ovechkin.
Penalty.
Oh. Backstrom and Ovechkin go after Cooke.
Ovechkin not feeling really well after that hit.
There has been a carnage factor in this game. 2-0 Capitals late.
Max Cooke kind of goes on a straight line, but what he really should do is come on an angle and force Alexander Ovechkin to one area. But since he's going flat, that allows that middle of the ice to open up. He sticks his knee out.
Power play for the Caps. Accidentally on purpose, Edzo. He leads, looks like, with the shoulder, but he leads with the leg. And Matt Cooke, when he played here in Washington, was very tight with Alexander Ovechkin and Nick Backstrom. Not so much anymore that he's changed alliances and allegiances.
Kemper would give them an advantage. They feel he's much better than Brizgalov at handling the puck. Tyson Berry taken down by Cooke, and that's going to be a penalty to Matt Cooke as he takes down Tyson Berry with a knee, and Berry is slow to go back to the Colorado bench.
Berry just went by me there and said, I'm done.
That would be a shattering blow for the Avalanche.
Tyson sticks his knee straight out here. He's trying to make the hit face to face. You can't make that hit because your shoulder can't get out in front of your knee far enough to make the hit. Hopefully Tyson Berry's okay. As I said, he skated right by me and said to the trainer, I'm done. So I don't know if that means he's done for right now or he felt something that is far more serious than that.
Now, Ray, do you think the league might review that?
Well, they should review it.
Playing Penguin hockey to try to vanquish the Boston Bruins here today. But here's Lucic into the zone. Drops it off, and a high shot sails over the shoulder. Oh, one of the Bruins. One of the Bruins just got blasted.
Matt Cooke, the hit just as that shot was released. And they're going at Cooke right now. And one of the Bruins on his backside.
Well, that's scary. Whenever you see a player down like that and all by himself in the middle of the ice.
Well, the puck was there in the middle of the ice, and the man had just released the shot. I'm not even sure who it is, Steggy. And I see the eyes are open. Not moving, though. The hands are moving. And let's take a look at the right side of the screen here. Is that Mark Savard? I don't know. Left-handed shot, 91, and then there's the hit.
Oh, blow to the head there, and Savard went down, and he is not moving any more than just a little bit, still on his back.
I don't think there's anything called on the ice.
Chip Burke, the Penguins doctor, is coming out. Savard has had some injuries this year.
Well, they've already had issues with Patrice Bergeron.
They sure have, and there's a stretcher coming onto the ice. This is the unfortunate side of the game. General managers have been discussing these very things, these kinds of hits that result in players being injured with blows to the head, whether intentional or not, or careless, whatever you want to call it. You can't avoid the subject. It's one that is prominent right now in the National Hockey League. And you see why. You see why it is so sensitive right here.
Well, Mark Savard just finished releasing that puck from the high slot area and was following his eyes, tracking that puck as it went in up over top of Marc-Andre Fleury. Wasn't in a position to protect himself there. And there's Patrice Bergeron talking to Sidney Crosby. And he, 37 of the Bruins, knows so well as he has a conversation with Brooks Orpik as well. And he's shaking his head, Patrice, right now.
Well, don't forget, you talked about concussions. How about Patrice Bergeron?
Yeah, that's what I mean.
He's a guy who's very, very sensitive to that subject. And Matt Cooke feeling remorseful right now. You know that. I mean, there's no way he's feeling anything but sad about what just happened. You can't take it back.
Certainly a hush over the crowd here.
Mm-hmm. Everybody's, a lot of the fans are standing up right now down on the lower level.
You know, Mark Savard's been injured quite a bit this season, as well as Milan Lucic. And Penguins, Chip Burke, I think you mentioned, and Chris Stewart down there as well, as they put him on that stretcher.
Mark Savard, you played with him, Bob. I know you have a lot of respect for the way he plays the game. He's a great playmaker, one of the real creative passers in the game.
One of the best in the game. Top five passers.
He's been amazed that when he's been healthy and how he's been able to almost match Joe Thornton's numbers, who he was traded for, but Thornton left and then they acquired Savard in his place, and he's put up very similar numbers to Thornton over the first couple of years, with the two players going in different directions. Of course, Thornton going over to San Jose and Savard coming from Atlanta to Boston.
Well, they can ill afford to have an injury like any extended time for Mark Savard to miss out of this lineup. They're lacking the production as it is, and without Mark Savard there, you know, who are you going to tap to get your production going?
Well, Savard gets a hand from the fans here at Mellon Arena, and applause from the Penguins players and Bruins players as he's lifted onto the stretcher here in Mellon Arena. Dr. Chip Burke actually hails from the New England area. Came onto the ice to administer to Savard, and the fans on their feet here in the building. Very concerned, as we all are about Mark Savard. Did lift his hand to gesture to the crowds, and that's a good sign as he goes off to the ambulance.
5:37 left on the clock, and there was nothing called on the play.
Shooting gallery on this power play for the Senators. Alfredson was wide open. He tried a slap shot, and it gave Fleury time to get over in a one-timer. He really anticipated well. Alfie again shooting. That one off the crossbar.
And that one went into the netting, and they didn't whistle it down. It went off the crossbar into the netting. We're still playing.
Craig Adams with a puck, and he shoots it wide of the goal.
What incredible.
11 seconds to go on the penalty to Paul Martin. Well, the Senators had a golden chance with Daniel Alfredson wide open, and now Erik Karlsson's been banged up. He's really hurting, too.
Yeah, he's really hurting. I don't know if it's his blade that was broken or it's his knee or his ankle, but he's really
as soon as he put weight on it, Bob, he just winced in pain.
And he just threw a stick. He did that across season. It cost him a two-game suspension. This one was because of injury. Brian Murray, management of the Ottawa Senators, as Carlson's being escorted down the runway, and this is not a good sight for anybody. Let's take a look. Oh, skate. The skate of Matt Cooke, like it came in and hit the Achilles tendon area of Karlsson, and he reaches for it right away. You can see the skate of Matt Cooke come up and hit him, and there's the great save by Fleury out of the corner with his right pad, anticipating that play on the power play for the Ottawa Senators. But it appeared that the skate of Matt Cooke inadvertently caught the back of Karlsson's leg, and that's why he tried to get off the ice. Right in that Achilles tendon area, right above where boot of the skate is. There's no protection in that back area. That's very dangerous. Very scary.
Saber zone. Big hit by Kennedy on Leopold. Following on is Cooke. The Penguins are buzzing right now. They're taking the body and they are playing their game. Very physical hockey right now from Pittsburgh. Tyler Kennedy working. He draws a penalty here from Leopold.
And then Cooke comes in with a shot on Leopold.
And now Monador and Cooke.
Monador's on top of Cooke. Got him in a headlock. The Flowers at the bench here. And, there we see some shots from Cooke on top. Monador.
Boy, Cooke is really upset after we don't know what happened to him on the near wall when Tyler Myers took that penalty, and then he scored the goal, and he's just all wound up right now.
So he's got the start goal, of the game. The goal. He's looking for the fight. Does he have the assist? Not yet. So you know, he's getting his way there, but he's always in the mess ups, and that's where he's supposed to be. That's why he's a Stanley Cup winner. 3-2 Pittsburgh right now. Don't go anywhere.